Where you focus determines how you feel. And we have gratitude exercises in there. Philippians 4:8, think on whatever
think on these things.
True, right, lovely, worthy, excellent. That's so important, which is why focus is a pillar. If you believe every stupid thought you have, you're going to be anxious, you're going to be depressed, you're going to do emotional eating, because those foods are addictive and they do make you feel better for a short period of time. In the long run, you'll never be able to fulfill your purpose.
What motivated me first about the Daniel plan was not, I wasn't afraid of dying, okay? People said heart disease. I actually, no matter what I was eating, my arteries were pretty clear. I were pretty plaque-free. But when Dr. Amen said, Rick, do you realize that the more weight you put on, your brain is actually shrinking? We call it the dinosaur, what do you call this?
The dinosaur syndrome. Big body, little brain. You're going to become extinct.
And, you're going to become extinct.
And in the United States, 70% of us are overweight. 35% of us are obese. It is the biggest brain drain in the history of our country.
You don't want to get dementia, and you don't want to have a brain fog, and you want to think clearer. You want to make those good decisions. And so this is why one of the five things we work on is called focus. Most get healthy plans are based on willpower. And it's sheerly, I'm going to force myself to do this. It doesn't feel natural, but I'm going to force myself to do it. What you have to do for long-term change is change your focus. And this is a brain issue. The example that I like to give is if I'm in a boat on a lake, And I have an autopilot, and the autopilot says, go north on the lake. And let's say I want to turn the boat around, and I want to go south, okay? I want to make a 180-degree turn in my life. There's two ways I can turn that boat around, and there's two ways I can change my life. One is by changing the way I think. One is by changing willpower. Willpower is like this. If the autopilot says on the boat, go north, I can grab the steering wheel and I can force the boat to head south. And the whole time I'm heading south, I'm under tension because everything in the boat is saying, go north, go north, go north. And I'm forcing the boat to go south. And inevitably I get tired and I let go of the wheel and I give up and I start smoking again. I go back to all my old foods, my junk. I go back to the bad habits and relationships, the codependencies, and all of those habits, hurts, and hangups. I go back to my addictions, things like that. The better way for change, the biblical way for change, is to be renewed in the spirit of your mind. Okay, and that's change the way you think. If you're acting depressed, it's because you're feeling depressed. Right. And if you're feeling depressed, it's because you're thinking depressed thoughts.
Right.
If you want to stop being depressed, you don't work on the behavior, you work on the thoughts. If you change the way you think, it'll change the way you feel, and that'll change the way you act toward food, toward your husband, your wife, and anybody else. This is the power of focus, and it's one of the five F's of the Daniel plan.